Welcome to the news about the games people play. It's been a great basketball season for the 912 area code. Nowhere was that more evident than Saturday here in Milledgeville at Georgia College. That's where Windsor Forest, Beach Boys, and the girls of Pierce County all were playing for a berth with the state championship on the line in the GHSA AAA Final Four. The first game of the day saw Windsor Forest playing without their second leading scorer, Karan Anderson, taking on Thompson, and the Knights looking to take that next step. Javonte Landy getting things going for Windsor with a nice drive to the hoop, but Thompson would open up a little bit of a lead early on. Levanta Ivory with a three-pointer, but then it's Javonte Landy again doing the honors. He steals the inbound pass and will take it all the way to the rack for two Knights points. Then it's Devontae Bass making the nice move to the hoop as Windsor Forest keeps things close. More good work for the Knights off the break. Abasi Scott with the hoop and foul, and the game is tied. Windsor Forest, though, did their thing in the second half. Fourth quarter now, and they start to seize control. The Knights with the tenacity on the boards. One miss, two misses before Deontay Bass finally puts it in as Windsor Forest starts to feel it. More Windsor work inside as Dante Dorman gets the hoop underneath. Then Abasi Scott puts the exclamation mark on the victory as he slams it home. The crowd goes wild, and Windsor Forest punches its ticket to the state championship game with a 60-53 win.
We just at halftime, we just lucky to get to the team, unity, and just the one, and we just wanted it more than them. It's a big game, but all it is a game that we got to win. What's the gun?
Well, for us, it means everything. I mean, we've been to two Final Fours already. It's our third Final Four in the last 4 years. So for us to get to that game meant everything. This was the biggest game in Windsor Forest history.
The Beach Bulldogs looking to join Windsor in the state title game as they took on Cross Creek. And they were hanging tough early off the break. James Leach with a throwdown, and this one was getting good. But Cross Creek would open up a lead. Ahmad McCain with a nice reverse layup, and they led by 7 at halftime. The Bulldogs, though, show tons of fight in the second half. They get multiple chances at the basket before Jermaine Saxon finally sticks it back in and draws the foul in the process, and the game was tied. Then Shamari Hughey drains the big three, and Beach was on top 41-39, and the crowd was feeling it. Unfortunately, Cross Creek would seize control. Deshaun Adams with a layup off the break. Then it's Adams again with a hoop and foul, and it would be too much for Beach as Cross Creek wins 52-43.
You know, it wasn't the ending that we wanted. We had the championship in sight. We just fell a little short, but we're gonna bounce back next year, I promise.
And one final team from the 912 in action is Pierce County's girls taking on Greater Atlanta Christian. The Lady Bears trailed most of the game in this one and tried to come back. Natalie Heron with a nice drive to the hoop, but Greater Atlanta Christian kept the pressure on. The long three-pointer increases the lead. Pierce County, though, would get as close as 6. A nice feed inside to Tafana Miles. In the end, though, Greater Atlanta Christian would prove to be too much. J.C. Bolden with a steal and hoop, as Greater Atlanta Christian ends Pierce County's season with a 66-46 win. Windsor Forest will now play Cross Creek Friday afternoon at 3 o'clock at the Macon Centroplex for the AAA state title.